As Marilyn Monroe so famously sang, diamonds are a girl's best friend. And for almost 70 years, the De Beers Company has promoted its engagement rings with the line, "A diamond is forever." A slogan so successful, it was voted the best of the 20th century by Advertising Age.
While diamonds may be forever, demand for them is not. They don't seem to hold as much appeal among millennials. To help explain why, we're joined by Adam Chandler, a senior associate editor at The Atlantic. Adam, good morning.
Good morning.
There's been a real cultural shift with this generation about this kind of thing, hasn't there?
Absolutely. We're seeing the American dream kind of being redefined. Millennials aren't buying houses or cars or even getting driver's licenses in the same way that previously did. So diamonds kind of fit into this.
Why did they lose their luster?
It's a great question. I think a lot of people are scratching their heads about that right now, too. Part of it is they're not living at home. Or they are living at home more, and so...
And they're not getting married. I mean,
they're not
look,
getting
if you look
married
statistically,
until
in addition to all the other things you mentioned, they're not doing.
They're not getting married until later, if they're getting married at all. And a lot of that kind of plays into this idea that diamonds are part of an older generation. And you want something that's more personal. You want something that's more linked to an experience or a story. And that is sort of what's driving this shift away.
That number we just saw was really interesting. Only 26% of millennials are married. That's the lowest number of any generation at the same age.
That's right.
And they're also more socially conscious, too. And does that fit into this?
Absolutely. This generation came of age with the most access to information than anyone else. So they're thinking more about things. They're looking at it differently. You know, you're not rushing out to buy a diamond ring. You're thinking about the ethics of it, the way that millennials also are flocking to a place like Chipotle more than, say, McDonald's, because they believe that it's more progressive, it fits who they are more, and that is part of the diamond conversation, too.
It's also interesting because so often when we talk about what millennials aren't doing, you talk about the time that they grew up in. And a result of that is seeing the economy go through so many troubles, graduating from college with debt. How big of a role is all of that? Just the circumstances they had that no other generation had.
Absolutely. As I said, the American dream is being redefined. A lot of that has to do with institutions changing, but wages staying the same. So millennials are really adapting to the new American dream, but they're also driving it, which is an interesting parallel.
Well, I mean, we look at this, there's a $1.3 trillion in buying power, but as Vanita pointed out, they also have an enormous amount of student debt. This adjustment is happening on a number of different levels. They seem to like experiences more than they like tangible things.
Exactly. They are spending more money on travel and more time on travel than previous generations, which is a really fascinating point. They really want to connect to an experience rather than a possession. You know, luxury is being redefined by technology, if you think about it.
Mm-hmm.
You pick up your smartphone, and that's a luxury item that you can use to be more luxurious. You can order breakfast to your room. In your apartment rather than staying at a hotel and getting room service.
So it's not a best friend, it's an acquaintance. That's,
right.
That's the way I have to look at diamonds.
You can't marry it, though,
yeah.
The phone.